and a beautiful rendition of O Canada by one of the alumni of St. Francis Xavier.
Oliver Menard.
Oliver Menard. It was a great rendition.
Good job, guys.
So now we're going to start this game. Coin flip between, it looks like, Ben Ehr, who's wearing the captain armband for the Dalhousie Tigers, and Michael Morosek, who is also wearing the armband for the X-Men.
Mike Morosek, all-time leading scorer for the Santa Fe X-Men as of last season, and he's off to a quick start, I understand, this season as well, Boston.
Yeah, very quick start. He already has 5 goals to his name, and the Santa Fe X-Men are actually 4-0-1 right now, Kieran. They still have an undefeated season. They tied UPI last week, a 1-1 game. UPI had a late goal in the 85th minute, and it was off a corner kick, so UPI always scoring, it seems, on their set plays.
Santa Fe ranked 3rd in the country at the moment, coming off a season where they were ranked 1st. Disappointing in the playoffs, though. They lost out in their first playoff game, so I think Santa Fe will be hungry this season to get back into the playoffs and really put their stamp on this CIS season.
Yeah, they're definitely hungry and very eager. Dalhousie also is 3-2 on the season, having a very good start to their year.
Campaign, yeah. Santa Fe's probably the favorites coming into this game. They're pretty aggressive on the offensive end of the ball, and they have that towering defenseman Mira Novak on the back line that really puts a stop to a lot of opportunities through the air, so definitely Dalhousie is probably going to want to keep the ball on the ground as much as possible when they're on their attack.
So Mannix playing it across for Dalhousie, and sent up to number 10, Julian Parada. Morosek now shields that ball right out of bounds.
We'll get a throw in here from Santa Fe. Taking their time. I think Thibault will throw it in here.
That's Martin Volk with the ball now to Dixon. Dixon was shielded well. Parada ends up with it. And the ball played out once again. Parada, nice bicycle kick. Ends up to Mira Novak, though. And Lures is able to head that out of bounds. So Morosek now, back to Thibault. Thibault clears it all the way up. Rogers ends up with it. Nice try by Martin Volk there. And Ben Ehr has the ball at his feet. So we'll see that towering kick by Ben Ehr, who's taking all the space given to him.
I think for him to get the ball to the opposing 30 right now would just be a chip shot. And there it goes. Right on cue.
Right to Parada. Thibault asking for it. He's almost able to pull through. Volk made a head of his hands in the back of like Zach Fisher playing in the center.
Boston, I had the I don't know, fortunate or unfortunate circumstances of playing against Jamie Thibault last winter season in Stellarton. I can tell you from experience, he's pretty quick and talented out there, so definitely look for him to use that speed on the outside, on the back end here.
He definitely is. Jamie Thibault, one of the fastest on this X-Men team. Ryan Casey with the ball now. Throws it into Volk. Volk plays back to Casey. Casey to Dixon. Dixon with some nice stepovers and switches the field for Mira Novak. Novak taking his space to around the 40. Chips it in. Finds Volk. Volk takes it off the chest. Ball bouncing around. Headed in. And it's almost in. Oh, and Graham Hodgins can almost have the ending goal. A great defensive play by Ben Ehr. And we're going to have a goal kick. Michael Morosek kicked that off of Julian Parada. So on the line, it seemed, Kieran.
Ben Ehr showing us why he's the captain and AUS All-Star on this team as he dove back to make that save.
Yeah,
pulling
Ben Ehr
off the line.
Ben Ehr, first team AUS All-Star, I believe, Kieran. Is that right?
I believe so, Boston. He's an experienced player in this league, and he's pretty talented. Rare miscue from Marosak there as he put that one high off the volley.
Josh Weinberger on the first corner of the night. Ben Ehr sending up to around the 35-yard line of the St. Evex zone. Max Mound winning that header. That's Every in the center. Mir Novak able to clear that away. Dalhousie regaining possession. Parada on the outside. Has Mannix. Mannix sends a cross in. Oh, and it's bouncing around. Still bouncing around. Mound with it. Excellent header off the line. And Mound once again clearing the ball away from danger. Dixon found Volk. Volk kicked in the Dalhousie to defender, but no handball, says the ref. That's Lewis in the corner. And that ball goes out. It's going to be a St. Evex throw.
Dalhousie not really trying to pin St. Evex in here. So they're giving them some space. Maybe a mistake, I think.
Ball played up by Hodgkinson. And that'll roll out for another St. Evex throw.
Looks like Dalhousie player number 5, Jordan Mannix, giving the linesman a hard time about that call.
And Parsons plays that all the way back up. Number 17, Lewis asking where the call was.
Probably not going to get that call too often when you're jumping backwards into the 6'7" Mira Novak.
No, that's for sure, Kieran. And Parada on the outside. Taken down, but all ball. Morosek able to strip a man and trip him up. And play back for Andrew McDonald. Mound now around the 25-yard line. Sends it up. Looking for Paul Oppenheim. Jamar Dixon to Marosek. Looking for Volk in the center. It's Engert in the center now for the Dalhousie Tigers. Novak tried to clear it, but Everair was there. And we're going to have a free kick. Jamar Dixon getting called for the penalty. Kick now. That's a low one. Mir Novak clears that around to the 50. Holly with the ball. Tries to kick it back out. Won nicely and brought down by Morosek. Morosek looking for Oppenheim, but Ben Ehr comes out quickly. Brings the ball to his feet. Parsons now to Engert. Engert getting tripped up with Hodgkinson.
It's probably going to be a corner there, yeah. As that deflected off the St. Evex player, Novak, and went out of bounds past the touchline.
Well, the first corner for Dalhousie. See what Dalhousie can do with this ball.
I think it's important for Dalhousie to get one early in this game. Saint FX is a pretty fit team and score a lot of goals in the second half. They're definitely in shape this year.
Wes Hawley took that corner. Inverted danger. Mannix now with the ball. Ooh, and it looks like it went off. Jamie Thibault on the far outside.
Do you know how many goals Mike Rosak has in his career right now? Because I'm looking at the website, but it's not updated. He's 31 going into the season. Are you sure? Because that's he had 31 as of September 26th last year. That's not the full season. I thought he was first in St. Louis.
Mrosek now with the ball. Mrosek back to Thibault. Thibault, nice turnover. And gives it right to Mira Novak. Novak switches fields to Max Mound. Weinberger tried to find Volk in the center. He's defended well against number 16, Parsons. Casey with the ball now. Throws it in quickly to Oppenheim. Oppenheim had a little bump in the back from, I think it was Hawley on the outside wing there, but no penalty awarded from the head referee. Ball cleared up from Mir Novak. Jamar Dixon coming on now. Finds Mrosek at the 18. Mrosek drags it back. Oh, there's Hodgkinson at the 6. Hodgkinson. Oh, he doesn't pull the trigger. Coach Graham Kennedy getting on his feet now. Wondering why Hodgie didn't just unleash fury onto Ben Ur.
Yeah, I think he was trying to avoid the block shot, as the defender wasn't in position, but maybe if he had taken that on the second touch or even the first if possible, then that might have been a great opportunity for Hodgkinson.
Yeah, sometimes you just take one too many touches, and I think that was the case right there, Kieran.
So you can hear a lot of chatter in the crowd as people are bantering back and forth about how that wasn't a goal for the home side.
Yeah, these fans thought they were going to get an early goal 10 minutes in to this first half. St. of X is in white for those of you just joining us. Dalhousie 0. Score still 0-0. Mound now up to Oppenheim.
Great speed there from Oppenheim.
Oppenheim does have great speed. Uses his body very well, Kieran. Volk now at the corner of the 18. Defended by Hawley and Hager. That's Zach Fisher on the outside. First time we're saying his name. Hard tackle there. And Jamar Dixon went down.
Usually if Jamar Dixon hits the turf, it's pretty legitimate. He's pretty strong on his feet and rarely goes down. He likes to kind of battle through all that hacking and grinding.
Chip from Mir Novak into no man's land. Paul Oppenheim actually ends up with it. Oppenheim still has the ball at his feet. And it's stripped now by Fisher. Fisher sends the ball up. Only one man to beat for Lures. And Lures and Mound going at it.
Going to be a throw-in right in the corner as that actually rolled over the black base of the flag in that left far corner.
So Casey will be taking this throw.
Looks like he's taking it from inside the yellow line, but obviously not. Trick of the light, I suppose.
Lights along with the field are all brand spanking new.
Absolutely. For those of you at home, the soccer pitch lines are obviously those in gold or yellow. I'm not sure what it's coming through as over the video, but don't be confused by the white football lines that are on the side. Once in a while, the players will make that mistake when they look down at their feet and see the white line and think that they're out of bounds, but they're really not.
And there's also blue lines on the field, too. Those are for the men and women's rugby teams. So this pitch is used for three different kinds of sports here at St. of X.
And if you include intramurals, it's used for much, much more. Ultimate Frisbee and... that's about it, I think.
Yeah, St. Vex does have a lot of extracurricular activities for the student body. Oh, nice ball there, and Martin Volk just away from that, and Rogers is able to try to clear that out, but he stumbled over the ball.
Well, the old step poke and swing and a miss. He might receive some razzing about that on the bench if he gets subbed off here.
A nice through ball. That's Everair. Everair sent it up to Lewis. Lewis, oh, defended well against Thibault, and that ball is going to roll harmlessly out of bounds for a Dalhousie throw.
Lewis is really getting a workout here today as his midfielders have been sending him on a lot of runs trying to take on the St. FX defense, sometimes two and three on one, so I'm not sure if that's the right strategy that they're going to need to get one past McDonald here, but we'll have to see if they make any adjustments moving forward.
Mannix on the throw now. Mannix still holding it. Finally throws it in to number 15. That's Eggert. Ball played safely away. Volk crashing down on it now. And Morosek unable to tap it by Holly. Thibault looking. Ooh, nice Meg there. Mark Volk ends up with the ball. Oh, Oppenheim thought used his body well there. Kind of came in with his bum first against the Dalhousie defender, Eggert, but called for the penalty there, Kieran.
Yeah, I think the referee saw the elbow come up just a little bit as he kind of shifted his shoulder in front. And he'll call that 9 times out of 10 if he sees it. Especially in the offensive zone where...
Ben Ehr with a towering kick. Almost to the 25. And there's Lewis there. Lewis takes a shot. Oh, and it goes wide. So a quick shot by Lewis around the 25-yard line. Oh, Andrew McDonald will be taking this goal kick.
See if he can compare to the boomer, to his counterpart, Ben Ehr.
St. Vex and Dalhousie are bunching right around the 50-yard line of Dalhousie. St. Vex has a knack to spread the field quickly. Thibault battling. Owens dropped down. But I guess that's fair play. Says linesman and the head ref. That was number 10 that took down Jamie Thibault, Julian Parada. See Ben Ehr's towering kick. Max Mound throwing his head in front of that one. Max Mound had the most headers on the team last year. Seems to always be in the right spot at the right time.
Yeah, looks to get up for those.
And he has a great vertical, so makes him quite the asset on defense. Eggert to the outside. Oh, Dalhousie still with the ball. Dalhousie tries to send it in. Jamar Dixon clears it right in front of Eggert. Oppenheim still with the ball at his feet. Battling through several Dalhousie players. He's not letting go of it. Finds a open St. FX player, Ryan Casey. Plays it back to Mound. Mound to Weinberger. Novak with it. Sends it up. Volk just not on the same page. Empty in the middle. Number 6, Rogers, is able to take that away easily.
I think with Volk, we may be seeing a little bit of a growing pain here as a first-year player, just kind of getting used to his new teammates, as maybe not quite yet has that chemistry there that the rest of them have been developing over the last 3 or 4 years.
That's very true, Kieran. Volk does have 2 goals and definitely looking to score more. St. of X sending in a lot of players now. Mound up from defense. Weinberger to Thibault. Thibault chips it into Volk, but over his head. Fisher on the outside. Looking for Engert. Nice ball by Mound. Morosek. Morosek back to Weinberger. Lures and Mound going hard against that ball. Mound's able to win that and send it back up to his counterpart, Mike Morosek. Nice tap by Casey to Volk.
Great turn from Volk.
Volk trying to send it in for Morosek, but unable to find anyone. Dalhousie clears. Mound switching fields. Finds Thibault in the corner. And Thibault let that roll out for a St. of X throw.
See what kind of arm Thibault has here, if he can get it well inside the six.
Sometimes St. of X elects to have Mir Novak take those. Thibault plays it back to Weinberger. Weinberger with a long cross, looking for Oppenheim on the other side. Dixon to Hodgkinson to Dixon. Nice give-and-go pass. Fisher was able to read that ball well to stop the X from coming back. Thibault. St. of X being very patient with the ball right now. That's going to go for a St. of X throw.
Yeah, heads up play there from the Dalhousie defender to put that out for a throw in rather than a corner kick. Especially with Novak, as you mentioned, now he comes in for the throw. Takes it short, though.
Nice cross in by Thibault. Hodgkinson has his foot on it. Still on Hodgkinson's foot. And Benner is able to pick it up.
Line drive.
Line drive by Benner. Able to catch the defense off guard. Parada with it now. Julian Parada, number 10. Battling against Hodgkinson. Sends it in to no one. Amir Novak for the X is able to pick it up. Michael now. Morosek on the outside. Doing several stepovers. Morosek back to Thibault. Possession is a big part of this, a big part of the game for St. of X. Ball played out off number 11, Hawley.
St. of X definitely enjoying the advantage in ball possession early on. Dalhousie kind of panicking a little bit whenever they get the ball, kind of just trying to pound it down towards McDonald to try and get some sort of odd man rush.
And Mound with a nice ball up to Ryan Casey. Ryan Casey, though, just out of reach.
This X-Men Soccer webcast is brought to you by the X-Varsity Club. Join the teams behind the teams. The X-Varsity Club is the fundraising entity for the St. FX Athletic Program. Your financial support is essential to our success in maintaining the tradition of excellence. Visit www.goxgo.ca to learn more about the X-Varsity Club or join today.
We were talking earlier, Kieran, that X-Varsity Club, anyone can really join. It's a great program. It gives back to the community. It's able to give these opportunities for everyone out there to be watching this program.
Absolutely.
So it's really beneficial. There's a lot of work that goes in. I don't know if everyone understands. We have video broadcasters. We have statisticians here. It requires a lot of donations, and it's something that we really appreciate. So if you would like to join, It would be great. We'd love to have you. You can be from anywhere, too.
Yeah, you don't have to be a St. FX fan. You can be a Dalhousie fan or any other fan, really. You can be a Yankees fan. We just like your money.
That Yankees term, obviously referring to the New York Yankees.
Yeah.
Baseball, the Boston Red Sox, who are my diehard team, are out of it. And I don't want to talk about it anymore, Karen.
I won't bring it up. I'm actually not a Yankees fan. I'm more of an anti-Yankees fan. We'll talk about that another day.
So now Dalhousie showing a little bit of possession of their own. Mannix now with the ball. Sends it clearing up to no one. Mira Novak able to corral that and send it back down. Andrew McDonald comes out of the net and has the ball at his feet. He'll take his time with this.
Last season, Andrew McDonald got sick halfway through the year, and he started as the starter, and then he kind of got sick and lost his starting position to Evan McCachern. This year, Evan's not back at St. FX, so he's kind of enjoying the benefits of less pressure behind him, but we'll see if the goalie is Sam Hutchinson or Steven Rodenheiser. It's a Rodenheiser can put some pressure on him to maybe challenge for that starting job.
Dixon now with the ball. So there's a lot of physical play here, but the ref isn't giving any yellow cards. So he's allowing the men to play, so to speak. Ooh, and Jamar Dixon. An untimely foul there at the top of the 18. As you're saying, Steven Rodenheiser played last week against, I believe it was Mount Allison, in the 2-0 victory. Played the whole second half and did very well.
It's good to see when you get an opportunity to play your younger players, get them some experience, because one day they'll be your older players.
Every looking for that ball, but is unable to come to him. Parada now. Back to Parada. Parada looks to the outside, sees Mannix all by himself. Thibault with a nice sliding tackle, but Mannix is still there. Mannix almost left all by himself. A dangerous play by Thibault. Because if he missed that, could potentially hurt Andrew McDonald and the X team by letting up an early goal.
Absolutely, but it worked out for the best as he was able to corral it off of him and back towards the goalie, or to McDonald for a easy pickup.
Jamar Dixon now sends a pretty ball, and then Mike Morosek. Morosek had one to beat and defended well by Rogers of the Dalhousie Tigers. Mound now with the ball.
It was a goal-saving tackle, I think, by Rogers there, as Morosek doesn't usually miss once he beats that last defender.
No, it'd be very uncanny if he did.
Yep, he's got 5 this season. That puts his career total in the AUS up to 36. That is all-time leader in goals for St. FX. The only player who ever played for St. FX that has more goals than him is Christian Krinsky, who got some of his goals for Dalhousie. So he doesn't quite lead St. FX's all-time total, but he is 2 ahead of him in the list right now, and he sits at 4th. So at 36 right now, that puts Morosek at 7th, and he definitely has a shot at challenging the second place, Jeff Hibberts, who has 47. So keep an eye on that this season.
And Parado is looking to score right there, but Mira Novak and his long legs is able to grab that ball and kind of wrap it around her shoelace and not let it go past him. St. FX pushing up. Jamar Dixon. Some very nice moves. Oh, and Morosek tried to play it back to him. Lures plays it up for Fisher. Fishing out Evrere. And Volk takes that ball from the 40 and brings it up to Paul Oppenheim. Oppenheim slides into it along with Hager. Both battling for the ball.
A lot of players hitting the turf here, whether it be sliding or falling after tackles.
Mrosek with the ball still at his feet. Ooh, and a hard tackle by Mrosek on Evrere.
So St. FX, in their game, most known for offensive pressure and getting balls to the net. Not really taking advantage of that this game. They haven't been shooting as much as they're used to. So far this season, they have 81 shots on net compared to 31 against. So,
yeah, a towering statistic.
Yeah, and if you just want to compare that to Dalhousie's total, they have 15 shots for and 20 against. So that's really some astronomical numbers for St. FX. So they really need to put some balls towards Benner and test him. He is a good goalie, but 100% of the shots you don't take don't turn into goals. So
very true, Kieran, very true. And we're coming up to our 30th minute here. Still 0-0. St. FX in white. Dalhousie in black. Josh Weinberger up to Volk. Volk with a pretty play in to Oppenheim. Oppenheim with the ball still at his feet. And Dixon was there. But Benner, his 6-2 frame, was able to wrap that ball up.
Maybe got a little bit lucky there as he guessed right and dove on the loose ball as it kind of collided. Two St. FX players collided as Oppenheim and Dixon were both trying to hit the same ball.
Mound with it. Another header by Mound. Finds Mrosek. Mrosek to Volk. Wes Hawley was able to clear that away, and Evrere has it. Evrere. That'll go harmlessly out for a St. FX throw.
X-Men Soccer and St. FX Athletics would like to thank our major sponsors for their continued support. Keith's Pepsi, Subway, Berger Grand Credit Union, Central Home Improvement, and Tim Hortons, as well as our media partners, 98.9 XFM, 101.5 The Hawk, and The Casket.
We have a substitution here. Wes Hawley will be exiting the game, and entering is James Nearing. Number 14, James Nearing, midfielder, just like Wes Hawley. So looks like Pat Nearing, the head coach of the Dalhousie Tigers, wants to do a little change here. Actually, we just found out that Pat Nearing, the head coach in his 13th year of the Dalhousie Tigers, it was his son that just came in, James Nearing. So it's kind of interesting, Kieran.
Absolutely. It's always good to see when coaches get to coach their kids.
Ball played in now. Oh, Andrew McDonald juggled it at first, but comes down with the ball. Evrere was the closest Dalhousie Tiger to strike that in.
St. FX X-Men football might want to recruit him as a receiver with hands like that.
Oh, well, they could probably use him.
They're not doing too well.
Paul Oppenheim on the outside. To 16. Parsons now. Dalhousie has it. Mannix with the ball. Dixon to Mrosek. Mrosek back to Dixon. Weinberger. DeThibault. St. Evex being very patient, pushing the Dalhousie Tigers back further and further into their zone. Thibault has a cross on. Morosek's there. Tries to head it. Oppenheim plays back to Casey. Casey, who had the goal last week, sends it into Volk. And Volk sends that low and wide.
Tough volley attempt from Volk, but he did well to get a foot on it. Unfortunately, it just goes wide of the net.
Yeah, it was low. I think maybe a little bit higher from Ryan Casey might have been okay.
Yeah, I kind of got caught between the one-hop bounce and the volley and kind of caught it off the one touch on the ground, so it kind of spun funny.
Once again, Mound being in the correct position gets another header. Weinberger with the ball. Midfield. Sends it to the right wing, Thibault. Thibault, the beautiful pass to Volk. Volk and Oppenheim just not on the same page. And Mannix, the Dalhousie Tigers, is able to corral that.
So once again, I think you're seeing maybe a little bit of growing pains from Volk as he's trying to get on the same page as his teammates. I'm sure that will come in the next game or two, though.
And that ball is played out.
Ball girl getting a real workout on that side of the field, as that's the third or fourth ball I've seen get kicked into the woods.
It's a good thing that when they built this new stadium, Kieran, that they put a fence around, or else she would be getting quite the workout then.
Yeah, looking in the parking lot. I think they hope they gave her a flashlight before the game. Or maybe a compass would help.
A compass might help. Volk with the ball. He's able to shield it well. Oppenheim with the left foot across. Looking for Hodgson. Casey's there. Takes a shot. Side netting, but outside.
Just wide. Great chance for Casey as he's pinching in a little bit from the fullback position.
St. Evex plays a kind of 5-1-4. They play four defensemen across the back here, and they have a holding midfielder as Josh Weinberger, and they almost kind of have five, you know, forwards with the wingers and then the striker up front. So it's an interesting type of formation that Graham Kennedy uses for this X-Men's team, and obviously it's been working very well.
Yeah, I think it has a lot to do with the fitness of his players and able to kind of rotate their wingers into the attack and be able to get back and defend at the same time. So he can afford to send a winger and a fullback back, or up, sorry, to attack and not be worried about them coming back on the defensive side of the ball.
Yeah, a very strong defensive core here for this X team. And behind the defense is the local, Andrew McDonald.
Oh,
who,
good.
As we know, is a beast.
Yes, he is.
Dalhousie moving it up. Evrair with the ball. Unable to find a target. And Volk sends a just a little too far ahead cross for Paul Oppenheim. And Ben Air plays it back out. Volk anticipating that pass by Hawley.
Volk, the third player on this St. FX team, native to the Czech Republic, so maybe a little bit of a connection there after bringing in Mira and Mike.
Yeah, the Czech connection, as it's called, it's quite strong here. Really benefited from the two Czech towers.
Yep.
And now we have another to add to the mix. So Parada, trying to play on the outside, was shut down. Enger crosses the field now. So Rogers to Hager. Hager up, looking for Evrair. Mistouched by Amir Novak. And Mound headed it back to Andrew McDonald. Great play. Oh, Mira, no, Morosek with the ball. Oh, almost cracked through the 18-yard line, but was stopped through a wall of defenders. Casey streaking against that ball. And that's going to go for our next throw. Mir Novak coming up from defense to take this. And before he throws it in, we're going to have a substitution. Coming into the game, Randy Ribeiro. Taking out Paul Oppenheim. Randy Ribeiro had his first goal last week. Oh, headed in. Bouncing around. Ribeiro gets his first touch. A blast. Another blast.
Wow, Ribeiro getting into the action early as he is able to get two shots on Benner. But Benner up to the task, makes two stops in succession here in the 40th minute of this 0-0 game. All squared up as St. FX and Dalhousie cannot break the goose egg.
Graham Kennedy almost having psychic powers, bringing in Randy Ribeiro, who almost had a goal and had two opportunities. So Randy Ribeiro making his presence felt early. Nice ball, and Engert has it. Tries to send it in. But Casey's there. Number 14, James Nearing, is unable to get to it. That ball is played harmlessly out by Mark Hagen. And we're going to have another X throw down in the corner. Samir Novak coming up for that last throw-in. It was definitely beneficial.
Probably a good play by Hagen to put that out as Jamar Dixon was buzzing around the ball, showing some speed trying to run onto it. He's a pretty dangerous offensive threat for the X-Men.
Parada tries to head it out. Ribeiro sends a low ball in. No one's home for the X team, and Dalhousie plays it across. Mannix now with the ball. And Mannix goes out with it.
Looks like this time they're going to send Mir Novak into the six to try and get a head on it if they can reach him.
So we'll see how Ribeiro throws as he comes up to the line. Oh, and a towering throw. Barrow's there. Ooh, elbows there by Rogers.
I was looking at the feed and I was curious to what that call was, but as you pointed out, a little bit of arm action there. That's definitely not 10 yards.
No, it's
only 5.
It's very easy to tell where 10 yards is. It's tough to cheat on this field as they're all clearly marked. So lining up here is Randy Ribeiro and Josh Weinberger. Ribeiro takes a shot low. Oh, and almost snipes the right corner. So Ribeiro again finding his way past the wall, and Ben Air with a beautiful diving save.
This is his third shot of the game. Probably the most on either team at the moment.
Ryan Casey coming all the way from the left side of the defense to come and get that ball.
That seemed like a fair tackle to some of these fans. Unfortunately, the referee saw it otherwise.
And most of these fans are probably X-fans.
I think so.
Though Dalhousie isn't that far away. More have started to come in. We must have near 1,000 here at St. of X. Here at Oland Stadium. Number 11 will be taking this kick. Hawley. Hawley sends it in. It's low. And Weinberger is able to head that away. Mannix now on the outside. Brought down high by Ribeiro. And it's going to be an X throw. So a beautiful tackle by Ribeiro. Getting the ball off Mannix's feet. And getting the throwing. Novak up now. Weinberger in that holding midfielder position. Sends the ball up to the corner, but no one's home. Volk with the ball now. Back to Ribeiro. Ribeiro finds Morosek. Morosek's double-teamed and unable to stay with the ball. Thibault plays it safely back. Mir Novak has it around the midfield. Mound on the outside. Chip in to Ryan Casey. Thibault with it. Thibault on the outside, taking his space. Takes it all the way to 30, brings it back out to the 35 to Weinberger. Weinberger sends it across to Mound. Mound with a nice chip in. Sees Dixon. Dixon's able to stay with the ball. Edgar clears it out. Ball trickling in. Ryan Casey has a cross in to Dixon. Once again, the Dalhousie Tigers defense is withstanding the storm.
St. FX definitely has a lot of ball pressure and possession right now. Dalhousie, though, holding strong.
Dixon with a nice move. Oh! And he was dropped inside the box, but the ref says get up.
So we're into the extra time now, 45th minute, and the referee calling for 1 minute of extra time.
Score still 0-0 for those of you just joining us here.
This X-Men Soccer webcast is coming to you live on SSN Canada, the streaming sports network. Visit the streaming sports network at ssncanada.ca. SSN, your sports anywhere, anytime. And they have a newly updated website this season. SSN Canada, it's pretty sharp. Got some red and some gray in there, as I'm sure everyone can see on their webcast screens at the moment.
Yeah, it's they completely revamped their website. Much more user-friendly, Kieran, and it's really a pleasure to find games that you want to watch on that.
Absolutely. Much sharper sight, much cooler, as the kids would say.
Yes,
more
much cooler. Hip, even. Yeah. So there was an injury on the play, and Mound plays the ball back up for Dalhousie. Good show of sportsmanship for both teams. And that's the first half. Whistle blown. And still, score 0-0. The Dalhousie men's soccer team against the St. of X soccer team in a very exciting first half.
Yep. I'd say it's really exciting, especially if you're an X fan, as St. of X showed a lot of pressure there and really just knocking on the door. If you're a Dal fan, though, definitely what more can you ask for if you've been outplayed and the score is still 0-0 at half. So still a chance they can make some adjustments in the second half and maybe get a goal and sneak a win out of this, or even get a tie. I think might be a small win for the Dalhousie Tigers at this point in the season.
I'd have to definitely agree with you there, Kieran. Dalhousie looking to spring on this St. of X team, trying to catch them maybe a little off guard. But St. of X weathering well, had a couple good opportunities in which there was the great save by Ben Eyre. It was almost rolled right over the goal line, but the whole ball has to cross.
Yep.
And he saved a almost sure goal. Ben Eyre playing very well for this Dalhousie team.
Yeah, and then later in the half, he made two fantastic saves on Ribeiro. So.
He did. Ribeiro had two excellent shots. Tough for anything else to ask for out of your keeper. He's doing what he can, pretty much standing on his head for this Dalhousie team.
Definitely the best player on the field for the Tigers, showing why he's the captain.
So I think we're going to take a 15-minute intermission here. If you'd like to come join us again, we'd love to hear from you. I think there's a what's the website, Kieran, that people can email us at?
The email address you can reach us if you have any comments or feedback is stfx.webcast@gmail.com. That's stfx.webcast@gmail.com. So feel free to contact us. Let us know if we're pronouncing all the names correctly or incorrectly, or if there's any kind of technical issues, we can try and handle those as well.
All right, and we'll see you soon. Hello and welcome back to our second half here at the Oland Stadium in Antigonish, Nova Scotia. This game of the X-Men soccer against the Dalhousie Tigers. I'm Jonathan Ambrose, and once again I'm here with my co-anchor, Kieran Gallivan.
How you doing, Jonathan?
I am doing very well, thank you.
That's good.
It was a exciting first half. 0-0, Ben Ayer for the Dalhousie Tigers in net. Played a phenomenal game. But we were unable to score.
Yes, Ben Ayer made three or four outstanding stops, some of them point blank, but he put them all to the wayside. And as we get geared up for the second half, I'm sure Santa Fe is going to want to really put the pressure on Dalhousie to kind of continue the momentum they had at the end of the first half.
Yes, that's for sure, Kieran. And we're just going to have our tip-off here. And Weinberger sends it up. Could go out of bounds. Ben Ayer stops it. I don't know what Weinberger was looking at there. I think he was trying to get Jamar Dixon on that outside wing. Dixon just a little bit too far away.
And Ayer with another monstrous kick all the way to the opposing 18.
Oh, headed in. And Andrew McDonald's able to pick that up. Andrew McDonald now. Rolls the ball out. Has a towering kick of his own all the way up to Michael Morosek. Casey now battling with number 14, James Nearing, who stayed in the game for Wes Hawley. So Pat Nearing changing up his offense.
Dalhousie defending well here. Say move the ball around the back line.
And Dalhousie sends it up. Oh, a tough header. That was Parsons on the left wing. Mond. Casey with it. Casey finds Volk. Mond battling. Does a little swim move against number 17, Lewis. Now out of position, and Andrew McDonald's able to come out and pick up that ball. Andrew McDonald plays it quickly outside of Jamie Thibault. Thibault sends it up to Dixon. Dixon's looking for Morosek in the center, but unable to connect. And Dalhousie looking to spring lures here early in our second half. Morosek with some space, but Dalhousie closing in on him. Plays it back to Weinberger, who crosses it over to Casey around the 50-yard line. Nathan Rogers going along the outside, looking for lures. Casey took down lures, still has the ball at his feet. Finds Ribeiro, who stayed in the game for Paul Oppenheim. Casey dangling against the yellow line. And an errant pass. Mond crosses it across to Novak. Dixon plays back to Morosek. Morosek looking for Volk in the center. But now that ball is played wide.
Dixon doing a great job there to create some space for himself. Sort of gives a little shoulder shake and stops the ball. Gives himself a good 5-10 yards.
Yeah, he's very strong on the ball. He's a workhorse of sorts, Kieran. He's always able to be in the right spot at the right time, which is very advantageous for this X-Men team. So we'll throw in here from Thibault. Thibodeau Morosek, back to Thibault. Plays along his back. Saint of X still playing with that possession game that they've been doing so well in this first half. Ribeiro tries to pass it back, but slips. Oh, I'm sorry. Hodgkinson tried to pass it back, but he fell over the ball. And Josh Weinberg appeared to lose his shoe on that play. Who's now running with one shoe and one shoe in his hand.
Is he actually playing only with one shoe?
Yeah. Lures now on the outside.
I think Weinberger should probably put that shoe back on. It's pretty useless to him in his hand.
You could also use it as a projectile, Kieran, but I don't know if that would be allowed here.
I don't think so either. It's an interesting strategy, though.
It would be.
Maybe he's going to get down on his hands and knees and use his hand as his foot.
Just like Adam Sandler and Happy Gilmore took off his skate and tried to throw it at someone.
Hopefully we don't see a repeat performance.
I doubt it. Now the ball played out to number 8, Hager. Hager tries to send it up to number 14, Nearing. Nearing comes back to the center and finds number 16, Parsons. Parsons playing around the center mid. Eggert now on the outside, battling with Thibault. And Thibault's able to send that ball out and send the ball retriever on a somewhat of a wild goose chase. That ball rose harmlessly out of bounds from the throw-in of Dalhousie, and Andrew McDonald will take this goal kick. Wasn't too many corner kicks that first half. Karen, only one per side. Usually the X-Men had two. Dalhousie's one. Usually the X is able to score on their set plays, but haven't sunk one yet.
Could be part of the game plan to not allow St. FX to have very many set plays, so Dalhousie playing a pretty disciplined game.
Jamar Dixon looking for a bicycle kick, and Morosek on the outside now with a 30. Morosek with a drag back, trying to bring it inside, and he'll get the call for the out of bounds. Thibault had to just play it in. There was no one calling for the ball or showing for the ball, so he had to play it into a Dalhousie player. And they send it up. Offside was whistled, but advantage play on towards X. Morosek now at the 13, 20, 25, sends it in to Volk. Volk with a shot. Oh, and he was not close enough to get that final touch on, and Ben Ehr picks up the rolling ball.
Another booming kick from her.
Dixon now. Megs his defender. Gives it to Marosek. Marosek's brought down hard. It's number 18, Aaron Hoyle. Weinberger. Outside. Morosek tried to play it back to Thibault, but couldn't find him. Novak steps up well. Anticipated that pass. Morosek with the ball still at his feet. Finds it to Volk. Volk takes one touch to the right. Still in the center. Dixon takes it, and he's going to try to finish it, and he does. A great play by Jamar Dixon. Burns through three Dalhousie players after the shot from Volk, and St. of X takes a 1-0 lead.
So some great great work there by the St. FX forwards as they really showed a lot of perseverance getting to the net and rewarded with the goal as they just kept trying and trying. And you had to think that the first one might be a messy one as Dalhousie's really been holding together pretty strong. St. FX now with the 1-0 lead, 53rd minute of the game. Goal scored by Jamar Dixon. Dalhousie now rushing down the wing, trying to get a goal back for themselves.
Number 15, Robert Eggert's now with it. Passes to Hoyle. Hoyle back to Hagen. Hagen back up to Hoyle. He goes down. Ribeiro hit him. But play on, says head referee. So Jamar Dixon, the goal scorer. is on the outside contesting that ball. Benner with it now. And Casey sends that up. Oh, and a high kick from the Dalhousie player. I think he wanted to clear that out, but didn't make it quite as far as he anticipated. So Ribeiro with the ball gives it to Casey, and Casey will take this throw. So for those of you just joining us, we're at our 55th minute. St. of X in white, leading 1-0 against Dalhousie in black.
Jonathan, we just got an email from a viewer. I'm not sure what their name is. Timothy Vanderwild, or Wide. Sorry if I mispronounced that. And I'm missing the action here. Sorry for interrupting the play, but...
It was a pretty crazy play, Kieran. I know you're checking the computer, but Jamar Dixon with a couple fancy touchovers and an errant shot.
Anyway, the email was just pointing out to us that James Nearing actually came on for Zach Fisher in the first half and not Wesley Holly. And to start the second half, it was Zach Fisher came back on for Julia Parada.
Oh, so Parada's out of the game. They obviously can see something that maybe we've missed. I'm glad that we're able to get confirmation via email through that. We thank you for your email.
We were actually told by our technician that we had no viewers tonight, so that's a pleasant surprise that we're getting emails.
Yes, we thought there wasn't going to be anyone listening, and we were simply talking to ourselves. Well, thank you for writing in. If anyone else has any emails, they can feel free to send us some feedback on the broadcast. It's ftfx.webcast@gmail.com. Free kick here, awarded for Dalhousie. Dalhousie looking to get some momentum back in their end and trying to push this St. of X team. Digging in. Oh, advantage could have been played on, but the ref says that there is going to be a booking here. Jamar Dixon with the first yellow card of the game. I'm sorry, no yellow card. Surprised that the advantage wasn't played on, Kieran, but Jamar Dixon just issued a warning, a final straw.
Jamar definitely has to be careful, Jonathan. He's a key member of this team, and he can't afford to be getting any cards, as it would force Coach Graham Kennedy to possibly have to take him out of the field.
A low ball in from Dalhousie. They chip it right back in. Number 17, Lewis, was offside, so he wasn't able to finish that ball home. Ball played back. Jamar Dixon almost there. That's Hoyle with the ball. Hoyle to the outside. Hagen. Hagen now dribbling along the right side. Engert's calling for it. Hoyle's with the ball, though. Pretty touch by Hoyle. James Nearing with the ball. And that ball's cleared up and out. Mannix on the left side is able to get that first touch on, which is so vital in soccer. Allows you to continue the pace of play. And instead, that ball went off his foot and out of bounds for our next throw.
So definitely not the first touch he was looking for, but he'll have to have a short memory and move on.
Jamar Dixon still playing physical, even though he has issued a warning. Parsons now. Plays up to mound. Weinberger has it. And now Casey. Casey on the outside. Playing along the wing. Volk has a nice touch. Hodgkinson's able to give it back to Volk. Volk sends along the outside to Morosek. Morosek sends it to Ribeiro. Ribeiro volleys one time. Oh, and Benner is able to get his hands on it and keep it away from Martin Volk.
That was an impressive volley from Ribeiro as he took it one touch on the left foot out of the air and just put it wide. Those are real difficult to control, and he showed a lot of poise to even put it close to the net.
Very true, Kieran. Very, very true.
So we're going to have the third corner of the match from St. FX coming in from the far side of the pitch. St. FX very dangerous on the set pieces, especially the corners, as Novak, 6'7", is a big target. Benner gets up to that one. Might be a one-timer here, and just past the post. Looks like, is that Dylan McKenzie out there?
No, Graham Hodgkinson.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Very similar frame, Graham Hodgkinson and Dylan McKenzie. Graham Hodgkinson's a little bit taller and younger than Dylan McKenzie. So Iver back into the game.
It was number 14 and number 18 for Dalhousie out, Zach Fisher and James Nearing.
That ball rolls to Benner. Benner with a towering kick and once again mound. There to get that. Rosek tried to beat Iver. Iver sets the ball up for his teammate, number 10. It's Julian Parada.
Looks like he's going to take this with his left, so St. FX will have to worry about this curling in towards the keep.
Low ball, and Ribeiro's there. Not the greatest free kicks from Parada.
Dalhousie showing a little bit of their own pressure.
Ooh, Mark Hagen trying to squeeze that in. That's going to roll out for a St. FX throw. So we're at our 61st minute. Here, if you can't see the scoreboard, St. FX winning 1-0. It's the Dalhousie Tigers.
It's definitely been a game that St. FX has held the majority of the ball possession. However, Dalhousie has had a few chances of their own.
Iver is rolling around on the ground, but there's no penalty on the play.
Yeah, that was definitely all ball first.
Iver with a beautiful cross to Thibault. Thibault almost overran it. Sends it. Had a nice heel kick to Graham Hodgkinson, but he originally overran that ball. Now Mound with the ball, sends in a cross. Look like there. That is the first booking. Robert Engert, number 16, for elbowing.
I think it was a required card as the game was getting a little bit chippy.
And number 7, Evrer, is still on the ground. The Dalhousie Tigers therapist is tending to him.
And as we take a quick break here, I'll bring the most recent and up-to-date thank yous to our sponsors. X-Man Soccer and St. FX Athletics would like to thank our major sponsors for their continued support. Keith's, Pepsi, Subway, Burgess Grand Credit Union, Central Home Improvement, and Tim Hortons, as well as our media partners, 98.9 XFM, 101.5 The Hawk, and The Casket. So lots of great sponsors that we really appreciate and help bring us this webcast. And another one of those sponsors is The Viewers. This X-Men Soccer webcast is brought to you by the X-Varsity Club. Join the teams behind the teams. The X-Varsity Club is the fundraising entity of the St. FX Athletic Program. Your financial support is essential to our success in maintaining the tradition of excellence. Visit www.goxgo.ca to learn more about the X-Varsity Club, or you can join today.
So that's a good sign. Iver is walking off the field, though, under the help of his teammate and student therapists. But it is always good to see him at least walk off.
I think he will be okay. It didn't look like too malicious of a tackle. I think it was definitely ball first, and then it seemed like he sort of fell over the top of the follow through. Hopefully he's nothing too serious. You never really know in these situations, but I'm sure that he'll make a speedy recovery, and if not for this game, definitely the next one. I mean, I'm no doctor, but...
Oh, yeah, by the way,
neither am I, Kieran. Though we both were in kinesiology and could tell you how the injury occurred, but we would obviously need something much closer. And now, Rosek takes a nice bullet. Oh, and who's there? Jamar Dixon once again.
Offside on the play. Very surprising call. Is that everyone in the stadium, including myself, thought that was onside and didn't even see the flag until after the fact. So,
wow.
No goal on the play.
I guess there was an offside, as you said, Kieran. I don't know. It looked like Dixon came from behind Morosek after the shot.
We'll have to take a look at the video after the game, I think, and double check on that. But obviously, you have to think that the lines person has the best view and made the right call. So here in the 66th minute of play, it's a 1-0 lead for the St. FX X-Men. They just made a substitution.
Yes, Graham Hodgkinson and Martin Volk are out of the game. Entering is A.J. Boogie Gray and Jesse Burgeons.
A.J. Gray, one of the more skilled players on this X-Men team. I think he's battling a little bit of an injury, as you said. That's probably why he's not starting.
Yeah, he had a calf injury and then started favoring one leg over the other, and I think just re-injured that leg once again, Kieran.
So it's good to see him back in game action. Hopefully he is able to stay somewhat healthy throughout the rest of this game.
That was great defense by Ryan Casey.
Great job to get the body position and regain possession of the ball. Short kick as far as Benner is concerned, but well placed and finds the winger.
Just a measly 50 yards.
Chip shot for him.
Oh, ball in the middle. Number 13. That's Zach Fisher. Zach Fisher almost had a good goal. Jesse Burgeon's getting his first touch, and Boogie also his first touch of the game, trying to dance around the players, as he says.
Now, Boston, this is the first time I'm getting a good look at Ribeiro for the X-Men, and I have to say I'm pretty impressed. He's shown some great prowess around the ball and some fantastic placement. He's got great skill.
Yeah, he's definitely going to be a huge asset down the road. First-year player, Randy Ribeiro. He's used to play on the Toronto Lynx. And we know that sports franchise is definitely one to be reckoned with. Andrew McDonald with the ball. Bouncing it a couple times. He sends it for a ride all the way up to Jamar Dixon. So Jamar Dixon almost had a second goal of the game. But St. Vex still winning 1-0. Morosek with a nice sliding tackle. Finds Dixon. Dixon to Ribeiro. Ribeiro sends a cute ball for A.J. Gray, but A.J. Gray is unable to get there. Weinberger battling. The ball's played to Ryan Casey. Weinberger now to Mond. Mond plays it up for Burgeons. Bergens with a big sliding tackle against him, and he draws the foul. So you have to be physical against Jesse Bergens.
Strong, low center of gravity on Jesse, and definitely tough to get the ball off him once he gets going with it.
So this is set up right at the 40. Ball played in quickly to Marosek for a 10-yard gain. Marosek takes a cross in. It's to Dixon. Dixon fell over. Ribeiro sends it across. Oh, and Mir Novak is at the doorstep waiting for that ball. And number 11, I think it was Wes Hawley, was able to head that away from danger. A great play by Hawley, because if he didn't get his head on that, that most certainly would have been a goal for Mir Novak.
Yeah. Novak is so vertically inclined that
he is.
Not quite much of a challenge for him to get that ball down and under the crossbar.
Definitely not, Kieran. I myself am vertically challenged. Nice cross in.
And they're going to call that a foul against St. FX. Mike Marosak, as they say, referee said he made a little bit of contact with the referee with the goaltender Benner.
Mark Hagen on the outside taking his space. No one's contesting him until Ryan Casey stepped up, read that ball well. Bergens has one to beat. Oh, Lures with an elbow into Mir Novak's head, and that's called for the foul.
This game is definitely getting a little bit more chippy.
Yeah, we're into our 71st minute. For those of you just joining us, the score is 1-0 for the X-Men. Ryan Casey asking for his 10. Nice cross up to Bergens. Bergens plays it back to Boogie. Casey to Bergens.
St. FX putting a ball possession clinic on right now. Dalhousie just chasing them around the pitch.
They're really showing how to play keep away. Dalhousie's running all over the place. Oh! And Lures. A very flagrant foul.
Josh Weinberger, not happy about that.
So he,
no card on the play. St. FX bench, kind of wondering why not. I'm sure a lot of the crowd is as well. It definitely was a...
Saw number 17, Tyler Lures, sprinting in from center field and just completely clipped Josh Weinberger.
I'm more surprised that there's no call, just because Lures has been pretty overzealous in the last 10 minutes or so of play, just in general going in pretty hard for all challenges, which is what you want from your players. But once you start missing those tackles by a little bit and start fouling guys, you expect the referee to kind of maybe step in, and he just got his warning there now, but you would think that maybe after at this point he would get a card.
It did seem a little flagrant to me, Kieran, but you know what? The X-Men aren't going to forget about that anytime soon. And they know if you can get away with a hit like that, then there might be one coming back for Lures. You never know. I know the Saint of X isn't the type to hold any grudges, but they are a physical team, just as the Dalhousie Tigers team is.
That sort of stuff is kind of conscious in all areas of sports, so it's sort of on the ref to kind of control the flow of the game and make sure that the players don't get out of control and take things into their own hands and stay within the kind of the context of the sport. Looks like Weinberger's coming off the field. I'm not sure who's going to go on for him.
Looks So Saint of X playing shorthanded for the moment, because he did go down and the trainer had to come out. It's Thibault on the outside. Thibault has a cross in. Oh, Dixon with a beautiful header. But up and over the crossbar.
So after a short break, Weinberger back on the field. Booming kick from Benner all the way to the opposing 40-yard line.
Number 8 will be throwing in this ball, Hagen. Hagen plays it down the line. Ryan Casey's there for the X-Men, though, and plays the ball back up. That's going to go out for a Saint of X throw. So we're into our 75th minute. We're definitely going to have more than 1 minute of stoppage time in this half, Kieran.
I think so, Jonathan.
Saint of X with the still a 1-0 lead from Jamar Dixon. Jesse Burden is able to win that ball. Finds Morosek on the outside. Morosek taking his space. Plays it wide, as this X-Men team has been known to do. Thibault plays it back. The possession game now. Finds Weinberger to Morosek. Morosek double-teamed. Beats two of them. Beats three of them. Takes a shot, but it's off number five, Mannix.
Sort of a bend-but-don't-break defense there from Dalhousie as they... As you mentioned, three of them were beaten by Mike Morosek, but Mannix there to save the day in the end, steps in to block the shot, and I think it was probably a shot well blocked.
So Barrow now on the outside. Has a cross on. Burgeons was the closest X-Men there, but I think he went up at a little bit of an angle.
Yeah, they'll call him anything on the back like that. Yeah, foul going the other way, especially in the 18.
So Ben Air. Crossover, looking for Parada. Number 15, Engert. Engert all the way over to Hager. Hager now coming up the left side. Sends another cross to Parada. Parada gets his head on it, but skims over the top of his head and rolls out of bounds.
Looks like a substitution here for Dalhousie.
Yeah, the striker in his first year, Sean Wallace, will be entering the game. Replacing number 15, that's Robert Engert. He's also in his first year. So Engert out, Wallace in. See if Pat Nearing sees something that maybe we don't. A.J. Gray plays it on the outside. Ryan Casey. Casey plays it back up, but he's giving the ball right back. Ribeiro. Weinberger to Dixon. Burgeons with the ball. Takes a shot, but again, off Mannix. Mannix in the right spot at the right time. One of Ben Zer's best friends. Oh, and Josh Weinberger has a penalty taken down from behind. Took down James Nearing, number 14.
Weinberger. Maybe getting a little bit testy after taking that shot earlier.
Parada with a cross on. Number 17, Lewis is there. Oh, and a low, slow header, and Andrew McDonald's able to easily pick that ball up.
Just a one-goal lead here for Saint FX. Anything can really change this game. They're going to have to be careful.
Yeah, last week against UPEI, the X-Men gave up a one-goal lead into the 85th minute off a corner kick, so definitely St. of X needs to watch the late goals. They're tough to rebound from, Kieran. Ball played up for number 11, Wes Hawley. Ribeiro now showing his speed and overall strength. Oh, and another penalty is given. And we're trying to figure out the number. That's number 13, Zach Fisher.
Zach Fisher's, he was warned already. That's why the card came out there. He's not too happy about it, as he got a little bit of a push after the play from Weinberger.
Weinberger now out of the game, and in for him is Michael Taint. Michael Tate. And Tate almost getting his first touch of the game.
Instead, he'll get a foul.
Instead, he'll get the foul. So Tate looking for an early first possession, but gets the foul instead.
Boomer from Ur again.
Then Ur sends it all the way up to St. of X 18. Mrozek brings the ball to his feet. A.J. Gray with it on his feet now. Number 6, Nathan Rogers. Finding the holes in the St. of X defense, pushing it all the way up to the 18. Now on the outside. Looking for the cross.
The second corner of the game, I think, for Dalhousie here. Definitely it's a little bit of a scary situation for St. FX.
Yeah, this is how it happened last week, Kieran.
Trying to hold on to this lead, see what Dalhousie can do.
Should we get a confirmation from our statisticians that it is the second corner of the game?
Yes, he's giving me the word now. It is the second.
Here's the cross. It's a low one. Miranovac's able to get his head on it. Ref actually stopped it, and it went pleasantly to Max Mond's feet. So Mond, with the help of the head referee, is able to get that ball and send it out. Mond again now.
Poorly played ball there through the middle.
With all my spare time, I figured rugby would be a good thing to watch. It is intense.
So Lewis almost made it past Mound.
He's getting carried in
there. I think Ribeiro is going to be issued a card for a delay of game. Kind of threw the ball up into the air. I don't know, it looked more of a pass than anything, but I don't think this ref wants the game to get any more chippy than it already's been.
I think I'd have to agree with you there, and unfortunately for Ribeiro, it's probably not the yellow card he'd want to take, as he's a pretty aggressive guy, so he's probably would rather take a yellow card on a challenge than a after the whistle type unsportsmanlike yellow card. Now he runs the risk of getting a second.
Hagen sends it across, but Mound is able to send that up to Burgeons. And Nathan Rogers drawing the foul against Jesse Burgeons.
It was a close play. Referees couldn't really see the ball behind the players.
Yeah, it almost looked like Jesse almost kind of grabbed him, but I think it was just the way he was falling, mostly trying to brace himself against the Dalhousie Tiger. So again, another free kick here. Chip in. Mond is there. A rifle!
Scores!
And what a goal by the Dalhousie Tigers at the 83rd minute. We were going to try to get confirmation on that.
So big shot and a goal
huge
for Dalhousie.
Philip Parsons to bring this game to 1-1. So as we were saying, Karen, boys are faltering near the end.
So number 16 with the goal there, that was Philip Parsons. And they're going to take a substitution now. I think Dalhousie's probably going to get into the time-wasting game.
So Aaron Hoyle now entering the game, taking out Sean Wallace.
Dalhousie Tigers goal to number 16, Philip Parsons. Goal was unassisted.
So here in the dying minutes, score 1-1. St. of X in white, Dalhousie in the black. AJ Gray, tup to Ribeiro. Through the shot, and Bergeron's trying to volley that.
Saint Effects now, I think, starting to panic a little bit, just trying to shoot from anywhere. They really should calm down and move the ball around.
They definitely have a sense of urgency now. They don't want to tie more than one game, that's for sure. One is too many in their eyes. Dixon now to Thibault. Thibault on the outside.
Right now,
that's going to go for a throw-in.
What I think you'll see the X-Men do is try to get the ball to their playmakers, Mike Morosek and Jamar Dixon.
Randy Ribeiro is going to be taking this throw. Going to opt for having Mira Novak in the center. This could be one of the best chances in the dying minutes of the game. Ribeiro's ball's in. Ben Ehr went over Mir Novak and appeared to hit him in the back of the head. But we're going to have a corner kick.
So again, another dangerous play for St. Effects. This is what their specialty is. They haven't scored yet off a corner today. Probably not the best corner taken. Kind of low. Not using the advantage of having those tall players in the 18.
Yeah, I'd have to agree with you there, Kieran. Almost a quick attempt. Really want to take your time on these corners. That ball's trickling through, though. The Bergeron's unable to make it in. Ben Ehr with his clock management kick. Sends it all the way back into the St. of X end. Ribeiro trying to get pushed off the ball. Bergeron's has it now. Turns around the corner. He's at the 18. Ribeiro comes back up with it. But Parada for the Dalhousie is able to clear it up. Looking for Lewis. Novak finds Morosek in the center. Ryan Casey with a beautiful turn. Crosses it in. But it seems like no one's home. Another cross through. Morosek with a bullet shot. Ben Ehr, I can't believe, saved a rifle. Absolute cannon from Morosek.
I can't believe that Mike Morosek got that kind of velocity on a shot from that type of angle. And a miscommunication through the middle there leads to an easy save for Ben Ehr, as I think.
Yeah, I think Michael Tate wants that one back. So it was a very poor attempt of a shot. But Ben Ehr sends the ball all the way to the 18.
So 2 minutes left in regulation time, and then there'll be some extra time added, I'm sure, as there was a few injuries this half.
So Tate with the ball still at his feet. Sends it across to Morosek. Morosek threading the needle trying to find Ribeiro.
Ribeiro stopped running on that. I almost thought he might have been able to control it if he kept going there, but maybe I misjudged the pace on the ball. So Dalhousie doing a pretty good job of that bend but not break defense. They'll go for another substitution here. Number 15 comes on for number 18, I believe it is. So that's Robert Engert back into the game for Aaron Hoyle.
Looks like the head referee is announcing 5 minutes of extra stoppage time. So there's still a lot of play here to go.
another 6 minutes or so in total. So St. Effects is going to want to keep this ball in play as much as possible, as Dalhousie will take as much time as they possibly can to try and get the point out of this game.
Nice ball across to Dixon, but Persians is unable to locate his fellow teammate. Thibeau now on the outside to Morosek. Morosek takes one touch past his defender, sends it across to Ryan Casey. Ryan Casey is able to stop that ball and keep it in bounds. And it's going to be a Saint of X throw.
I thought that was a poor ball from Mike Morosek, but Casey proved me wrong to show me that that was quite on the mark.
Yeah, and looks like Mira Novak's going to be taking this throw. This could be one of the last great opportunities for this X team. Sends the ball in. Benner is there. Flicks it down. Tate again with the ball. Takes a shot, but it's low and right to a defender.
Nice,
a beautiful slide there by Ribeiro. And for some reason, it's a Dalhousie throw. No idea why.
That was a very interesting call.
It looked as if number 15, Robert Engert, clearly kicked it out of bounds. So Tate with the ball. Back to Thibeau. Thibeau to Morosek. Morosek looking for Ribeiro.
Dalhousie's starting to turn it on a little bit here.
We're still into stoppage time. Score is 1-1. Dalhousie with a late goal at the 82nd minute.
A misplayed ball from Novak there.
And a bullet by number 16, Philip Parsons. And what a save by the local Andrew McDonald. That ball was dipping right in under the 90 crossbar.
Yeah, St. Effects is really going to have to kind of put their head back on straight here. After a great game, they're letting it slide, allowing the tie late here, and they almost allowed the go-ahead goal for Dalhousie, which would be absolutely devastating to them.
Yeah, we were mentioning earlier how great of a shooting percentage this Dalhousie team has. And as you can see, they have one goal on only a few shots, so their percentage is up once again. Ball played quickly to Mond. Mond tries to burn one defender, but Dalhousie's there. This could have been a time where you wanted to get a little bit more clock management if you were St. of X. You don't want to lose the point. And the ball is played up to Tate. Tate to Ribeiro. Ribeiro now makes his first person, but
St. of X getting themselves into a bit of trouble here as they're really not doing what they're good at is ball possession. They're trying to push forward.
Dalhousie now dropped another defender back, while still only leaving one striker. And Lures is doing a great job now. Number 14, James Nearing, trying to find an opening. And another free kick awarded. So Dalhousie now playing five along the back, trying to preserve this lead. And at some points, it's looking like they're trying to win this game. Ryan with a pretty cross in. Ball's there. Jamar Dixon with it at his feet. Wasn't able to finish. Ribeiro, still with the ball at his feet, is going in. And Dal
has
I don't know how that was not a corner kick, Kieran.
Yeah, that did seem to go off the Dalhousie player, however. Referee has the final say in the matter, and so we'll get a Dalhousie free kick. And there's another substitution, number 9 coming in for number 17.
Well, the weather fared well, Kieran. It was supposed to rain tonight. there was a chance of thunder showers, but I guess not. There she burgeons. Ball finds Morosek. Morosek unable to squeeze that ball in there. So a lot of stoppage time being added onto this game. And a free kick is going to be awarded for Dalhousie.
Jamar Dixon came in hard there on the challenge and missed the ball, so that'll be a kick going the other way. This could be the end of the game, as there's been quite a bit of extra time here to play so far.
They did say 5 minutes, but it seems like it's going on for quite a long time. Ball around the 40, played back in for Dalhousie. Ribeiro's there now for X, who sends it up looking for Burgeons. Burgeons and the fans clearly upset. And in a matter of seconds, Burgeons issued two cards, two yellows, and received a red.
Looks like Burgeons must have said something after the initial yellow.
Obviously upset with that call. It looked as if his body was in a good position, but...
Yeah, he may have a case there, as it looked like the Dow player kind of jumped into him, and it didn't seem like much of a foul either way, but definitely not a yellow card-worthy foul. He may have said something afterwards, and that's going to be the end of the game, Jonathan.
Yeah, Saint you don't effects. Think the head ref wanted that to continue on any longer.
Yeah, I don't think so either. St. Effects, once again, second game in a row, has given up a late lead to finish with a draw, and definitely not the result they were hoping for against a team, Dalhousie, that is definitely the underdog in this situation coming into this game. They didn't play particularly strong against the other teams. They did manage to produce some wins at a 3-2 record. However, they, as you mentioned, did it on a very high shooting percentage, so they haven't been controlling the ball quite as well as you'd expect a top-tier team. St. Effects, once again, did have a lot of ball possession, but when it comes down to it, you got to put the ball in the net, and today they were only able to get one in.
That's true. A very disheartening loss for the X-Men. Ben Eyre of the Dalhousie Tigers played phenomenal and really stood on his head for this Dalhousie team. Once again, the final score 1-1 as the Dalhousie takes a 3-2-1 on their season, and St. Evex still undefeated, not undisputed, with a 4-0-2 record. A very disheartening loss. I'm upset on this homecoming weekend, Kieran.
Well, it's not a loss though. It is a tie. So
there's a lot to learn too. I think, Kieran.
St. Evex will definitely be back to the drawing board, and Dalhousie. I'd say they probably got what they hoped for out of this game. They would have liked to get the win, and they almost did have it as they put a lot of pressure on St. FX at the end of the game and had another real glorious scoring opportunity in the closing minutes that was saved by Andrew McDonald.
Well-officiated game, and I'd just like to say thank you to all the friends and family out there listening and all the millions of viewers we had tonight. We're glad that you all could tune in for this X-Men soccer against the Dalhousie Tigers. Once again, final score 1-1. On behalf of myself, Jonathan Ambrose, and my co-anchor, Kieran Galvin, I'd just like to say a personal thank you.
Absolutely, and as always, feel free to send us feedback on the broadcast. We welcome any comments or messages. We can receive your emails at the following address, stfx.webcast@gmail.com, stfx.webcast@gmail.com. So feel free to email us and let us know what your thoughts are on the broadcast. And if you're interested in catching some more game action, the homecoming football game is tomorrow at 2 o'clock on SSN Canada. And again, we have some more soccer for you on Sunday afternoon. I believe those games are at 1 and 3:15. So please join us again tomorrow and on Sunday, and we'll be happy to bring you more and more joy, as I like to say. Then player of the game in the closing moments here of our broadcast has been brought to you by Subway, Ben Eyre, and Ryan Casey for the X-Men. So Ben Eyre definitely deserving of that for the the Dalhousie Tigers. So that'll just about do it for us here at the Oland Stadium. Hope that you'll join us again tomorrow and on Sunday, and have a great evening.